Welcome to the Dell Technologies Avamar How-To Series. How to run the Getlogs utility to gather Avamar server logs. Reference Dell Knowledge Article Number 22859. This video was created to demonstrate how to run the Getlogs utility on an Avamar grid. It will also show you how to locate any files associated with a previous rollback. The first part of this video shows the following. How to determine the currently running version of the GSAN on the Avamar grid. How to load the SSH keys based on the GSAN version. How to run Getlogs, and how to check the log file size. The second part of the video shows you where to check for logs associated with a grid rollback. It is possible that you will be asked to provide the logs by the Dell EMC technical support engineer to assist with troubleshooting. You may also be asked to provide any logs associated with a previous rollback. Before you begin, you will need to know the IP address and the admin password of the Avamar utility node. You will also require programs such as PuTTY and WinSCP for connection and file transfer. It should be noted that as the logs can grow quite large, the utility should be run from the admin home directory. Log in as user admin. If you don't know which version of Avamar you are running, type the command gsan --version grep head -1. As shown on the screen, this Avamar grid is running version 19.1, so we would load the SSH keys by typing SSH agent bash and SSH add.ssh/admin_key. If the GSAN was running version 7.2 or lower, the commands to load the keys would be SSH agent bash and SSH add.ssh/dpnid. To run the Getlogs utility, you can specify how many days of logs you require by use of the server equals switch. In our example, running Getlogs --server=3 will provide 3 days of logs. The utility will run and you will see similar outputs to those shown on the screen. Highlighted is the log file generated from our example, and the file you would provide to the Dell EMC technical support team. To determine the size of the log file, type ls-lh, followed by the log file name. If the size is less than 2 GB, it can be attached to the service request directly. If the size exceeds 2 GB, it will need to be uploaded to an FTP site. This information would be provided to you by your Dell EMC technical support engineer, if needed. If you are looking for logs related to a previous rollback, type ls-lh/user/local/avamar/var/log/rollback. The results will show up to the 3 most recent rollback logs. The size will again determine if the logs can be attached directly to the service request or uploaded to an FTP site. If you have any questions, please reach out to a Dell EMC technical support engineer, who will be more than happy to assist. Thank you for watching.